This video is sponsored by Squarespace. Start your free trial today at www.squarespace.com/secondthought to get 10% off your first purchase. Imagine one decision you've made recently. We all make hundreds of decisions every day, some of them much more important than others. Take, for example, your morning commute. Every day you go from point A, your home, to point B, your place of employment. On the way, you'll make numerous decisions. Should I go the speed limit or just a little over? Or a lot over? Should I stop for coffee? Starbucks or Dunkin' Donuts? Should I clip this guy on the bike who's clearly not in the bike lane? You get the picture. In each of these scenarios, you make your decision and move on, and any other possibilities become null and void. But what if you really performed all of those possible actions simultaneously? It sounds impossible, but the general concept is a staple in what's broadly referred to as multiverse theory. The idea is that for every potential outcome for any given situation, there is a separate and distinct universe in which that outcome did happen. So there would be a separate universe for stopping at Starbucks on your way to work, and another one for stopping at Dunkin' Donuts, each occurring simultaneously in their own unique timeline. If we extrapolate this to existence in general, there's an alternate timeline in which your favorite sports team didn't lose that big game, one where the Russians beat the United States to the moon. One where Henry Ford decided to collect stamps instead of pursue his idea of a motorized carriage. Basically, anything that could happen does happen, and things that couldn't happen also happen, but we're getting ahead of ourselves. The idea that there could be more universes in existence than just our own dates back to at least 1952, when Erwin Schrödinger stated that when his Nobel equations seemed to describe several different histories, these were not alternatives, but all really happened simultaneously. That being said, it's nearly impossible to pin down a date for the inception of multiverse theory, because it consists of many very different and often fundamentally opposing hypotheses. For example, the idea of parallel or alternate timelines exists not only in physics and astronomy, but also cosmology, religion, philosophy, and psychology, not to mention science fiction and fantasy literature. But let's look at the scientific side of things. What kind of support is there for the theory of multiple universes? Well, not much. There has been and continues to be heated debate over whether or not multiverse theory holds water. But more than that, many scientists believe that not only is the whole idea silly, it could erode public perception of real science and damage the study of fundamental physics. Harsh accusations, to be sure, but not without cause. The basis of the scientific method is asking a question, forming a testable hypothesis, gathering empirical data, and evaluating the findings. The scientists opposed to the study of multiverse theory suggest that this testability is the key issue. How can any experiment rule out a theory if the theory provides for all possible outcomes? This is a valid concern, but for the sake of this video, let's explore a few different possible types of multiverse. The American theoretical physicist and string theorist Brian Greene lists 9 possible variants of multiverse, each with unique characteristics. We'll take a look at 4 of the more interesting ones. First, there's the possibility of what's called a quilted universe. This explanation only works in an infinite universe, but if we assume that our own universe is infinite, it's not an unreasonable hypothesis. In a quilted universe, since distance and time is infinite, every possible event within our laws of physics will happen an infinite number of times. However, the speed of light would prevent us from ever seeing the evidence of such identical sections of universe. That seems fairly straightforward, right? Let's look at a slightly more complicated variant. The membrane, or brain, hypothesis suggests that many separate universes exist in three-dimensional form within a larger multidimensional space, or bulk. Think of it this way. When you buy printer paper, you get hundreds of sheets bundled inside a wrapper. The wrapper is like the bulk, and the individual sheets of paper are unique universes. Within this bulk, the universes can drift around and interact with one another, and every few trillion years or so, drawn together by gravity or other forces we can't yet comprehend, they collide with one another in a violent explosion, triggering what we know as a Big Bang. At that point, they could bounce off each other like billiard balls, combine into a new super universe, or, perhaps most likely given our current understanding of the Big Bang, spark the creation of a new universe from the violent destruction of the old ones. Then there's the theory most reminiscent of the example at the beginning of this video, the quantum universe hypothesis. This version of the multiverse theory suggests that a new universe is created every time a diversion event occurs, such as choosing to call in sick to work. There would be one universe based on the consequences of going into work like normal, and another new one for the events that transpire after calling in sick. This multiverse would grow exponentially and infinitely, as every person on Earth makes hundreds of decisions every day. and those decisions cause a new set of decisions, and so on. It's a fascinating theory, and one that seems to capture public interest more than others. Finally, there's the ultimate multiverse hypothesis. This one tends to draw a lot of criticism from the scientific community, perhaps rightfully so. The ultimate multiverse hypothesis suggests that it would contain every mathematically possible universe under different laws of physics. That last part is what gets it in trouble. Not only does it consider our laws of physics, the ones we assume to be universal, but it goes so far as to say all possible universes within all possible variants of physics. There's simply no way to test the hypothesis, which relegates it more to the realm of philosophy than hard science. Of course, many scientists consider the multiverse theory as a whole to be more philosophical than empirical. Whether they're right or not remains to be seen, as so far we don't have any evidence for the existence of any universe but our own. But hey, maybe we're in a universe where the laws of physics don't allow us to detect the billions of other universes floating all around us. I'd like to take a moment to thank my sponsor Squarespace for making this video possible. Squarespace is a sleek, super user-friendly platform that lets you create stunning websites with zero experience required. Some of the world's biggest companies, celebrities, and even your favorite YouTubers use Squarespace to build their own professional websites. If you watch Real Life Lore, you've probably heard about our super secret project we're working on. He and I are currently designing our collaborative website with Squarespace, and we'll be sure to share it with you when we're done. As a little thank you for watching, Squarespace is offering my viewers 10% off your first purchase with them. Just go to squarespace.com/secondthought or click the link in the description to sign up and start building your online presence. That's squarespace.com/secondthought to start your very own professional website today. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to subscribe to keep up to date with the latest content. You can watch my previous video by clicking here, or if you're really bored, you can watch all my videos by clicking here. Don't forget to check out the new What a World Instagram, and if you'd really like to support my channel, consider becoming a patron on Patreon. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.